led by powerhouse vocalist Amy, sing-off alums Delilah exploded on the stage. Proving their girl power supergroup is a force to be reckoned with. You won't do
the same. That was great. You guys were singing your asses off. It was really great work, and you've really accomplished something, and welcome back, all of you.
Whoa, that was our first live performance, and we all felt like we just killed it. It was such a rush of, like, we can do this. This could actually be something amazing.
Why don't we have you start it off, and then we'll start building harmonies on top of that?
This week has been a lot of pushing and trying to go further than what we did last week, so it's going to be even more difficult to really raise the bar even higher. There might have
been a time. Our current hit is What Do You Want From Me by Adam Lambert. I wouldn't even
try. It has been really difficult finding the perfect arrangement.
When Ingrid comes in, it can maybe pick up the pace a little bit.
We just felt like, you know, we wanted to just sink our heads and we wanted to kind of give up because the arrangement was just not working.
I don't want to end the happiness, but you guys still need to watch a bitch. Just
don't give up. Having a second chance at the sing-off means a lot. We don't want to disappoint. We have to get it right. We set the bar, and so we can't fall short.
I mean, it's definitely going to be risky, but I think we kind of have to take that risk. Like, we have to do something big, like go big or go home.
This needs to be better. This needs to be an A plus instead of just an A. And we have to get it done now.
Will they give the judges what they want? Performing What Do You Want From Me by Adam Lambert, here is Delilah. Delilah! Very, very nice. Sean, your thoughts?
You kind of gave people a window of how harmonies are built just by singling out each one. Kendall, you were the key to it all, because if you were off key, then everybody else would have been off key. You starting it off and everybody else joining in, and Joe came in with that thunder bass, you know, to fill up that whole harmony, man. I was like, oh, man. But that's what it's all about. The drama was there. The feeling was there. You captured us with the feeling of the song. I understood what it was talking about. Great job.
Ben?
Sean just said it. We understood the song. And in fact, I've heard the song a million times, but I understood it better that time than I had the million times before. The choral approach was really slick, really smart. What people might not know yet is you've got even more depth on the bench. You're basically all stars, so you could do this again and again. Everyone's going to get a new voice every time. That's really impressive. But overall, this is the reason that I do this gig, because you're developing and you're innovating something, but you're doing it with heart, and it's all happening in real time on TV on our show. So thanks a lot.
Sarah?
I don't feel like it's fair that I want to call you my girls, but like I'm so excited that everybody's getting to see how stunning a group of women can be. You guys are obviously all powerhouse vocalists. Kendall, you just took your time and you set the tone and the pace for the whole song, and you had me at hello, what do you want from me? That's what you had me at. And then Joe, what a strong, strong voice you are. You add so much. And Amy, you are such a powerhouse, but you came in a little sharp for me there. So you got to be careful just to stay in tune with everybody else. But I loved it top to bottom. This was a Pink song that Adam Lambert made famous, but girl power, baby.
Okay, we'll see you again later on tonight. Thank you, Delilah. When we return, we've got a Rapapella twist on a Black Eyed Peas hit. And later, all six groups rewind to the retro sounds of the 60s. The Sing-Off. Keep it tuned.
We had a message that we wanted to get across, and for them to tell us that the message was received was really special for us. Yeah.